So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. In this session guys, I will bring to you 5 important questions from the PIB news which are important for various government exams, especially for ESI section of RBI Grade B. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the sessions. So let's begin with the very first question. So the fourth edition of India Mobile Congress 2020 has been announced to be held in December. So this India Mobile Congress 2020, it is the fourth edition and it will be held in the month of December 2020. So it will be jointly organized by Department of Telecommunication and Dash. So you have to fill this gap guys, that it will be jointly organized by which two departments. So one is the Department of Telecommunication and second you have to tell. So let's discuss about this news. So this India Mobile Congress 2020 has been announced. It's the fourth edition announced where it will be held in the month of December in collaboration. It will be jointly organized by the Department of Telecommunication and COAI. And COAI stands for Cellular Operators Association of India. All right. Cellular Operators Association of India, it is a non-profit organization established in the year 1995 and the current chairperson is Mr. Ajay Puri. Okay, Mr. Ajay Puri is the current chairperson of COAI and he is from Airtel. Right? And the theme of this India Mobile Congress guys will be Inclusive Innovation, Smart, Secure, Sustainable. Inclusive Innovation, Smart, Secure, Sustainable will be the theme of this India Mobile Congress 2020. Okay. So I hope this news is clear, and now let's come to the question. So we have to fill this gap, which says that it will be jointly organized by Department of Telecommunication, and of course Department of Telecommunication is under the Ministry of Communication, right? It is under the Ministry of Communication and Dash. So this Dash is what? Cellular Operators Association of India, which is currently headed by Mr. Ajay Puri. Okay. And now let's move on to the question number 2, which is about the World Oil Outlook 2020. Okay, so the question says we have to consider these 3 statements about this World Oil Outlook and we have to identify the correct statements. Okay, so we have to identify correct statements. So let us first discuss about the World Oil Outlook. So first of all, remember it has been released by OPEC, Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. And if you talk about OPEC, so it was established in the year 1960 in Baghdad. It was established in Baghdad by 5 countries. And which are these 5 countries? Iran, Iraq, one more we have Kuwait, then we have Saudi Arabia and Venezuela. Okay, in 5 countries ne milke isko establish kiya tha in the year 1960 in Baghdad. Currently it has 13 members. How many members? It has currently 13 members. And it is headquartered in Vienna. It is headquartered in Vienna, which is the capital of Austria. And Vienna also has the headquarters of guys International Atomic Energy Agency and also one more UN Office on Drugs and Crime. Alright, so this is about okay. And talking about the key highlights of the report, so global primary energy demand will increase by 25% till the year 2045. 2045 tak jo global energy demand hai, usme kitna increase ho jayega? 25%. And oil is expected to have the largest share in the energy sector, and that is how much? 27% by the year 2025. Globally, oil demand is expected to increase from 100 million barrels per day in 2019 to 109 million barrels per day in the year 2045. So in 2019, the requirement of the oil is how much? Was how much? 100 million barrels per day, while it will increase to 109 million barrels per day till the year 2045. Okay, and this report also tells about India. So India is expected to be the largest contributor to the incremental demand. India jo hoga incremental demand mein largest contributor hoga, adding around 6.3 million barrels per day between 2019 and 2045. 2019 se leke 2045 ke beech mein India will add a demand of 6.3 million barrels per day between 2019 and 2045. Oil demand in aviation sector is the most affected by COVID-19 because we all know international flights were cancelled because of this pandemic. So in the aviation sector, jo oil demand hai, that has been worstly affected. And the global oil sector will need an investment of $12.6 trillion by the year 2045. ताकि वो अपने ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट से ऊपर जा सके और वो प्रॉफिट में रहे ऑयल का सेक्टर. एंड द नेचुरल गैस विल बी द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग फॉसिल फ्यूल बिटवीन द ईयर 2019 एंड 2045. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन योर एग्जाम कि व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फॉसिल फ्यूल विल बी द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग फॉसिल फ्यूल बिटवीन 2019 एंड 2045. सो द आंसर विल बी व्हाट? द नेचुरल गैस. ओके, सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. सो वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स. It has been released by International Atomic Energy Agency. So is it International Atomic Energy Agency? No, guys, it is OPEC. So this statement is incorrect. It has been released by OPEC. And till 2045, solar energy will have the largest share in the energy sector. It is also incorrect. The largest share will be of oil. Oil ka sabse zyada share hoga in the energy sector. And oil demand in transportation sector is most affected by COVID-19. So it is transportation sector. It is also one of the transportation sector, but the correct word should be aviation sector. All right. So this statement I consider as incorrect, which means this is also incorrect, and therefore the correct answer should be what? None is correct. So option E, none is correct, will be the correct answer because we have to identify the correct statements. Okay. And now let's move on to the question number 3, which is adding one more news to the Atal Innovation Mission. So guys, there are various information about the Atal Innovation Mission. I'll bring to you a separate session about all the initiatives under the Atal Innovation Mission. So ye ek naya initiative aur launch ho gaya, Atal Innovation Mission, which is an innovation program in collaboration with DASH to foster innovation amongst youth and to develop technological solution for India and Russia. So this initiative is between Atal Innovation Mission and an organization from Russia. Okay, and you have to identify which of these organization is this. Okay, you have to fill this gap. So this organization is Sirius. Okay, Sirius is the organization which is located in Russia, and along with Sirius, Niti Aayog's Atal Innovation Mission has launched an innovation program which is known as AIM Sirius Innovation Program 3.0. And 3.0 means this is the third edition of this program. Okay. So, AIM Sirius Innovation Program 3.0 and it has been launched to foster innovation amongst youth and to develop the technological solutions to combat the global challenges in both the countries, India and Russia. Okay, and this news mein hum itna hi padhte hain, isko zyada detail mein padhne ki zarurat nahi hai, no one will ask in the exam. So, therefore, here the correct answer should be what? Option A, Sirius. Option A, Sirius, and all these are the companies from Russia. Remember the names, and there is one more company which is from Russia also. Remember the name of this company also, Gazprom, which is an oil and gas company. And talking about Russia, so India is in a talk to buy spread light SDM-1 tanks. Spread light SDM-1 tanks from Russia. We do a military exercise Indra with Russia, and Russia recently test fired a hypersonic cruise missile. Okay, so can you name that missile? Hypersonic cruise missile, they have recently test fired. Write down the name of the missile in the comments. Hypersonic cruise missile, they have recently test fired, Russia. So write the name of this missile. Now let's move on to the question number 4. So guys, question number 4 and 5 are based on the government schemes. So let us do this question. So a scheme for improving the labor room quality to reduce preventable maternal and newborn mortality, morbidity and stillbirths was launched in 2017. Okay, so the basic objective of the scheme is given. Alright, so what is the basic objective? To improve the labor room quality. Okay, and it was launched in 2017. So the launcher is also given by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So the ministry is also given, which means you have three, the most important hints are already given in this question, and you have to identify the scheme. So now you can easily identify, I hope, to improve the labor room quality and maternity operation theater. This scheme was launched in the year 2017, and the name of the scheme, guys, is what? Lakshya. Labor room quality improvement initiative. Labor room quality improvement initiative is the name of the scheme, and I hope you all know about this scheme, Lakshya. It was launched in 2017. Let me repeat this. To improve the labor room quality and the maternity operation theater, ताकि हम preventable maternal deaths को रोक सकें, stillbirths को रोक सकें, neonatal mortality को रोक सकें, right? So here the correct answer is what? Option A, Lakshya. And the question number 5 is also based on government scheme. So to promote the best breastfeeding practices, a scheme was launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare in 2016. So again, the most important three things are already given. The launch year, the ministry, and the basic objective. So, what is the basic objective? That is to promote the best feeding practices. Launch year is 2016, and the ministry is Minister of Health and Family Welfare. Under the scheme, it is mandated that all the health facilities should have a dedicated room for breastfeeding, identified as a scheme. So, this reminds me of the India's first monument, which has a dedicated room for the breastfeeding. So, can you tell me the name of that monument? Which monument is jiske andar a dedicated room banaya gaya tha for the breastfeeding, and it was India's first. So, write down in the comments the name of this monument. So, here, if you talk about this question, best breastfeeding practices, the basic objective, launched in 2016, and the ministry is Minister of Health and Family Welfare. And under the scheme, jitni bhi health facilities hai, sabke andar ek dedicated room hona chahiye for the breastfeeding. Alright, so the correct answer to this question, guys, is option C, MA, which stands for Mother's Absolute Affection. Option C, MA, Mother's Absolute Affection, will be the correct answer here. Option C, okay. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope the session is clear, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.